Donations to Abiding Grace reflect your response to God's love. So everything we have, according to God, is His, and He wants us to keep, and He wants us to flourish and to thrive. But for me and for my husband Paul, donating to this church, particularly our home church, is really important to us because it supports that ministry that is supporting us so well. So the more we can do for Abiding Grace, and the more we put into that, and the more we provide for Abiding Grace, the more our Abiding Grace community can provide for us. And in response to God's gifts to us, we feel very blessed. We feel like it all has come from God's blessings, and so we're very happy to share and happy to give back and provide a way for our ministries to continue and for us to reach more people and bring more Christians into the kingdom. Well, it's important to know that it's not all about writing checks. That's great when you can, and very important to the life of the church, especially while we're trying to grow the way we are. But your time is just as important. There's always a core of people in every volunteer organization that seem to do everything. And while that's wonderful that those people can do everything and want to do everything, it's challenging for the church then. And it doesn't allow for growth of the future generations. So if someone has the smallest inclination to help one time on one project, I hope they'll step up. And I hope they'll offer that and volunteer. The other thing is just to simply pray for the church. It might be the most important part. So if you're praying for the church, if you're praying for the pastor and his family, if you're praying for the people that you love at the church, everything else will fall into place. I think there's one other way, and that is to reach out, not only to each other in the church, but remember our job is to go and make disciples. So it's not really donating to the church, but it's donating to the kingdom when you go invite people to know Christ and to come to our church. Well, even Paul had to make tents for a living, and I think we all have to have a job where we make our living. But I think my purpose in this world, in this place, in this moment in my life, is to be strong for Abiding Grace, to be working for Abiding Grace. It gives me a sense of purpose, a sense of completion almost, and it helps enhance my gratitude when I'm involved in what's going on at the church and I see so much and I get emotional sometimes. I'll look around, you know, while we're at church and I think, I know all of these people and I really know them. I know their names, I know their children, and the reason for that is I volunteered in a lot of capacities. So if you're just a pew warmer, you don't get to know anybody. And if you come and you volunteer and you're on committees and you sing and whatever it is that your heart wants to do, you get to know people and it's just a lot more fun. When Paul and I get into a church, we get into a church. We kind of dive in feet first. We just do everything, almost anything we're asked to do as volunteers. And sometimes it gets a little overwhelming. But that sense of love and family and community and friendship and the fact that I know I can reach back out to anybody because we've become close, it's really our whole world, and it's the reason that we feel so strongly about it and that we get so involved. We know that this is just a tiny, tiny glimpse of what heaven will be.